Well, many of us grab a quick coffee and maybe a quick piece of toast for brekkie, but are we getting the right nutrition from it? We better bring in the expert. He's chef, restaurateur and food writer, Bill Granger.
Hey. How are you all? Thank you.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Bill, you're pretty much the king of breakfast. People travel from all over the place for your eggs and your corn fritters.
I have based my career and life on breakfast. It's all grown from scrambled eggs.
But it's so good. And yeah. And not enough of us eat a good brekkie, do we?
Oh, absolutely. 44% of Australians don't eat a regular breakfast, which just is astounding. Mm. It's so important. It fuels your day. You know, you just don't want to miss it.
What are some of the reasons behind it, Bill?
Look, I think I've noticed my 14-year-old daughter doesn't want to eat breakfast now. I think she's got things on in her head. Mm. She wants to, you know, get started in the day. And I think it's that. It's busyness, thinking about what's going on. Mm. You know, at dinner, none of us ever miss dinner because you're stopping for the day and you're relaxing. And I think that's what it's about.
So what can we do? What are some, I suppose, quick but nutritious ways to fuel us
Absolutely.
Up for
well,
the day?
Well, you've got to think with breakfast. It's got to be fast. You've got to be prepared. Mm. So make sure you've got your shopping in the fridge. That's the most important thing. I love, you know, avocado on toast.
Yum.
But put some protein in there. So a poached egg, a boiled egg, a handful of nuts is great.
Nuts on avocado.
Yeah, just sort of chop them up and sprinkle. Mm-hmm. It's delicious. Bit of lime juice.
Yeah.
Some chili flakes too. That's a cook in me. What do you do?
Truffle oil.
Yeah. I mean, some yogurt, berries and granola.
I love
these
this sort of thing for brekkie.
Oh, yum. Lovely. I poached some fruit there. But if you haven't got time, berries are brilliant because you don't even need to peel them. You know, mangoes yogurt and some cereal on top is delicious.
And what about frozen berries? Is it okay to get those?
My middle daughter, what she loves doing is getting a handful of frozen berries, some yogurt, mashing it up and almost making ice cream.
Mm.
Yeah, she's a bit of the cook of the family and she likes to add her own touch to it.
Mm. Ron was asking before in the break about genetically modified
organisms, food. GMOs. In the United States, they use it so much. All of our corn, all of our wheat is becoming genetically modified. Even the soybean is technically genetically modified. Is that here?
I always try and eat foods as close to their natural state as possible. Mm. And that's, you know, with everything I do, you know, fresh fruit and vegetables. It hasn't hit here so much, you know, that, you know, there's much more of a, you know, for me it's about things being, you know, natural, organic and smaller farmers.
Mm. And you've also got, what's that?
Oh, that. Well, when I was growing up, I loved cheese and tomato on toast.
Mm.
That was my favourite thing. And this is a bit of a variation of a grown-up weekend version of this. It's a tart with ricotta and parmesan, so you're getting the protein there, and fresh tomatoes and basil. And it's a great weekend brunch dish. Have people over, salad, and you've got a perfect weekend brunch.
Oh, yum. Fantastic.
Mm. And they say, just quickly, you need to eat within the first sort of 20 to 40 minutes of waking up. Otherwise, your metabolism doesn't kick into
gear. Well,
that's
the important thing. And if you don't eat breakfast, what happens is you snack later on in the day. You know, at morning tea, you'll go for something, you know, a pastry or something that's not healthy. So breakfast and eating it keeps you going to lunch.
Mm. Now, talk to us about rise and dine.
What we're trying to do is encourage everyone to get up and take 20 minutes just to sit down at the table. And, you know, that can be with the kids to talk, because I often find when you sit around the table...
Really?
I know, I do. I do with my kids. I get them to sit at the table, 20 minutes, and do it. Yeah, how are yours? Are you sort of like, whipping them into shape?
Yeah, that's
Yeah, have you got your sports bag?
They won't eat.
It's funny, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's why I find a yogurt pot in the car even,
even
if you've got time to sit down, is a way to get them fed.
All right. And Bill Granger has brought in Jordan's cereal for everyone in the audience. So you're all going home with a full stomach. There it is. And really healthy, this stuff as well, right?
Great.
Chuck a bit of low-fat yogurt on top, some fresh fruit. You're done.
Absolutely.
Terrific. Thank you very much, Bill Granger, the king of breakfast, everyone.